Hi. Thank you.
You're welcome.
This is
It's interesting, right?
Yeah. I kind of almost got lost on the way here.
My dork is
I hope you don't kill
you.
Me.
No, it's okay. You didn't want to wear makeup today?
Excuse me?
I mean, I figured you'd wear makeup. It's a date.
No.
I'm not so sure about the outfit. That's pretty casual.
We're sitting in a fucking...
We're going for a hike. I don't know why you're wearing flip-flops.
First of all, you made me meet you in a random fucking forest. I'll probably get poison ivy on the way home. Second of all...
I'm pretty sure it's a skip, but low-key, has anyone heard from that girl since that date?
Everyone's always like, when are you getting married? When are you having kids? Never! I plan on being the single, fun, crazy, rich, bad bitch forever! I want everyone to look at me and be like,
that my best friend, she a real bad bitch, got her own money. She don't need no nigga on the dance floor. She a 2-3 drink, that's me, bitch!
They really think they'll be 20? One forever. She thinks she'll be attractive forever. Also, do you really think she's the one paying for her high-rise apartment or her dad? At least, she's practicing the stripper pole for later in life. Oh, by the way, subscribe.
So I matched with this super cute guy on Tinder, right? And he's like, hey, found you. I was like, have we met before? You look super familiar. He's like, hey, maybe through someone I know. And I was like, maybe in my dreams, ahaha, playing along. And he's like, go to Michelle's house. And then it hit me. And I was like, wait, Michelle T? And then he said, let me seduce you. And I was like, oh, wait. This is Michelle. My best friend. This is Michelle, looking all cute. And this is her older brother. So I'm going over. Hey.
Hey. Hey. Bro, which one of you? We're trying to build a society, and this ain't it. To be honest, I still can't tell if these are skits or what. I'm probably the one being played as a fool.
Touches you on the first date, he's not that into you. A guy who's 100% into you will be slightly scared of you.
She's not wrong. Guys who are intent on what they want and making sure they're going to get it when they want it are going to try right away to see if it's going to happen. Have you heard the term microaggressions? Guys who just want to have sex with you aren't going to immediately push you into a bed. They're going to escalate the level of touch to see how much you're going to take, how much you're going to accept, how much you're going to say yes to. Their intention is to get you into bed and they don't want to waste any time. If you're going to turn down those little touches, if you're not going to say yes to a first kiss on the first date, they're going to say goodbye. I'm here to get what I want when I want it. Men who are intent on a committed long-term relationship who look at you and go, ooh, something about that girl, don't want to risk turning you off. Don't want to risk offending your boundaries. They are much more cautious and careful in their approach. They are respectful.
Actually, they both are not wrong. That's exactly what I do on a date. I'll try to touch the girl on the shoulder or hand or anything. If she's not having it, then we're splitting the check and she's sent to the block party. But I don't understand the part where the grandma said nice guys should wait longer to touch the girl. That's the best way to enter the friend zone.